What is this? Justice Buffalo? Dignified Tantalo? Rhyming. Hello guys, welcome back to another video of Exos Heroes. This is Boss Alpha Gaming, and in this video we are going to discuss about the new announcement which is already live in the game. The new banner which we have is Fate Core and exclusive weapon Chance Up for Dignified Tantalo. Before we begin with the video guys, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please hit the subscribe button and let's begin with this video. What do we have in the announcement part is the new banner which is already live. Sorry for not posting this earlier, I was actually occupied with some other things and didn't got a chance to cover this particular banner and the abilities and everything in advance, so I'm just covering this so that you can get some idea on whether you want to go for it or not. Okay, so I will summarize the overall details at the end of the video, so please do watch till the end. Let's begin guys. So we have Tantalo, Banga of Parallel World, who was born as a Banga and became a general of Saint Waste. Small in stature but praised in invincible fighter in Saint Waste with his volatile personality and innate physical strength. Okay, the event is going on from today till Monday 28th of September. What is the hero? The hero here we have is Tantalo. Now you see the shield, it is a buffalo. Nice. Yeah, shield is nice, the guard is nice. So they have made a pretty good character. Let's go for the skill changes. So what exactly we have in the skill? Okay, so they have actually changed or adjusted the skill. What they have added? Overpower and Sworn Friend. First, let's see. Afflict all enemies with provoke 10 turns. If an ally takes damage and its health drop to 30% or less, and grants heal over time to self that heals 20% of the attack. So it is basically similar to Ulum, where you heal 20% of the attack dealt to you. Okay. Gain mana if own health is 20% or less when triggered. So you have to be less than 20% health, then only you can get one mana, which is pretty scary considering that most of the champion doesn't survive after 20% of the health, because of the fact that we have finishing moves in some characters like Baraka. We have Deva, I think, also have this ability where she uses the finishing blow. Okay, so we have many characters which can overcome the effect of Tranquil. Okay, now Dragon Knight Blessing increases damage dealt to dragons with the dragon scale of order activated by 250%. Overtime effect is decreases the enhanced dragon fang effect used by the nature element dragon of order by 20%. So it will be effective when you are playing against the green stone dragon. Heart strike, this is the one which afflict heart rate level 1 to 1 enemy with one enemy with the highest health when battle starts. Increases level of mark when a target with the mark is damaged by an ally with the heart strike skill. Obtain 1 mana per enemy mark level at the beginning of turn. The effect of the mark increases as the level increases and it stacks, all effect can't be removed, which is pretty nice. Afflicts heart strike level 1 to 1 enemy with highest health upon marked target's death. So basically what will happen is at the start of the fight they will mark an enemy who is having the highest health. Okay, and based on the level of mark, what will happen is you will gain 1 mana on that based on the mark, and this particular mark will be switched back to another enemy if you kill the first one which was already marked with harsh strike. Okay. So the choice how the system works here is they will select the next highest level maximum health champion and then they apply the mark to them. Okay. Now how exactly these level of harsh strike works is first is decreases 20% attack speed of the target if it is level 1. Then once you hit back again with any of the Banga family champion, okay, you cannot increase the level with any regular champion. You need to use Banga family Fate Core champions to increase the level. Now Heart Strike level 2, so basically if you hit the champion again with Banga family character, then they will apply Heart Strike level 2. The debuff is 1000 defense of the target will be removed. Okay, so it means that it will be much more easier for you to kill that particular champion. Now when you again hit the champion, then it will apply level 3 mark. When the level 3 mark will be applied, deals 200% damage to all enemies upon activation. So first time it will do 200%. Status effect: afflict target with blind. Overtime effect: afflict 2000 damage to target every turn. Okay, so basically once you apply level 3, it will be very difficult for the champion to actually recover from that. Now what we have next is overpower. This is the new one. Overtime effect: decreases critical damage of the target by 300%. Wow. So this particular ability is amazing. However, if I think that how many champions are actually providing you a buff that you can increase your critical damage, then I don't see a lot of champions in my list which can do that. Overall, I would say at the current state of the game, I don't think that there are a lot of champions which can be nullified or actually taken control over by this particular ability. Okay, there will be few, but I don't think that it is going to impact a lot of champions. However, the 300% decrease in critical damage is way too high than what exactly you actually get in any champions, right? So when we go back into the game, I will show you how many champions have a critical damage and what exactly would happen. Okay, now Sworn Friend grants damage immunity one time when an ally takes critical hit damage. So it is not including the current damage. It means that if someone hits you with a critical hit, then the next turn would be a damage immunity. So one time, it is not a turn, sorry, it is a one time. So basically you will, once you get hit again, that then it will be applied. But for the current hit, you will anyways face the critical hit damage. Okay, now we go for ground flip skill is unchanged. So basically here you will deal 127% damage to all enemies. Overtime is poison the target, dealing 44% for 3 turns. All is what? Increases attack of all allies by 13% of own attack for 9 turns when the skill hits. All increases block of all allies by 42 for 18 turns when the skill hits. Okay, so overall I would say when you are doing this ability, it will be actually much more beneficial for all the allies in your team, because you are gaining first the attack of all the allies and then you are also increasing the block of all allies. And that is nothing but for 18 turns, which is amazing. However, there is a condition that you need to hit. So basically, if the opponent dodges this attack, this won't be applied. Now, body check. This is also unchanged. What we have is 262% damage to one enemy. Over time, poison again 92% damage for 4 turns and decrease attack of target by 35% of own attack for 8 turns. Okay, so overall I think it is pretty good support character, I would say. Okay, what do we have? It is a gold rated fate core, so you will get a get 0.5% chance, and then you will have to summon for 28 times. Okay, now exclusive weapon. Once again guys, I don't care a lot for exclusive weapons, because overall it just gives you more majorly on the combat power thing. But if you see here, we have plus 30 attack for Tantalo, plus we get combat power. So I don't go for any exclusive weapon for any of the champions. I only go for the champion itself. Alright guys, here we are with the skill preview. As you can see, he is too small, I think, compared to other champions. So let's go into the skill preview. Let's see how this action seems like. Okay, it's a pretty standard. Let me see. Oh, wow. Okay, so this is the poison effect. Did you looked at the tiles? It all started glowing green. So the effect of poison, nice. And what is this? This is body check. Okay, so let's see. Nice. Okay, so nice actions here. Let me see again, ground flip. Okay, this one looks amazing. And you have you seen the defense shield here that got increased? So basically this is what we have in the skill preview. So guys, just to give the overview of the skill, and I will just rate it on top to bottom, what exactly I feel about this champion, and whether any person need to, or any player need to go for this particular banner or not. Okay, so coming back to the passive skills, where we have already discussed Heart Strike for any Banga family, if the opponent is actually not immune, it will be very much beneficial. So at least even in Dragon also, you can do only till level 1, which is I think 20,600 or somewhere like that damage, which you can do, and after that this mark ability will be gone. You won't be able to use it any longer for the second phase, third phase, like this. Okay, so you can just completely forget about this particular ability once you are, if you are using this champion in Dragon. So Heart Strike I still don't consider on the very high end. However, if there is opponent which is not immune to mark ability or Heart Strike ability, then it would be easier for you to clear. Okay, so for this one I would not suggest that you go only for Banga family or for FC Tantalo banner. Now we go to the next passive ability, which is going to reduce the critical hit of the opponent by 300%. Okay, however, please note that the entire game is not about critical hit. There are champions with so much attack power that they can actually clear FC Tantalo or any other champion in one go without using critical hit. Okay, so overall on paper this looks pretty good. However, I don't see that you need to actually rely on critical hit to clear any opponent. Yes, in major of the game, or like in major chapters, once you break the enemy, then you can clear them. And if they have a lot of health bar, then after breaking, if you are applying critical hit, then it would be much more beneficial. However, this is not going to add critical hit to your team. It is only going to reduce the critical damage of the opponent. So in this term, I would say whether considering this one, whether we need to go for a pull or not, I would say no. We don't need to consider this skill for the summons. Next one is the damage immunity. Now this damage immunity is one time. Like you have FC Lapin where you get damage immunity, so it will save the team member. However, I don't think that that particular champion will last forever. Considering overall Heart Strike, Swan Friend, and then we have Overpower, then I would summarize it in one go, whether you want to go for this banner or not, or whether you should go for this banner or not. My answer is a complete no, provided you already summoned under the previous Banga family banner, okay, which was I think before this reverse core banner. And if you have already got any of the Banga family, I would say don't go for Tantalo. Preferably, if there would be an option, I would have opted for Morris or for Adam, because they have a counter ability and that would actually help you clear the sections more quickly. If the opponent hits you, then you will be able to counter back and increase the mark from level 1 to level 2, level 2 to level 3. So for a free to play player, whether this champion worth your this, no. If you haven't got any of the Banga family character and you have enough Zs, I can say that you can go for it. I don't think that PvP content will change because of this champion. However, maybe in story mode this champion can be used in some of the aspect where like in chapter 11 or somewhere you can try the passive abilities and the active abilities where you increase ally attack and ally block as well. So that would be added advantage to your team. However, overall, if you already got any Banga family character, I would say you can actually skip this champion. So right now, if you see on my screen, these two champions, I never went for any of these champions. I got it from the pulls. Normal pulls, or you will be able to see that in the previous video how I got FC Morris. So that's it guys for this video. I hope you like the video, and if you have any question, please leave a comment. And before we close the video, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. Thanks a lot guys, see you next time.